তর্ক অপতিষ্ঠ শ্রুতয়ো বিভিন্ন নাসৌ মুনির্যস্য মতম ন ভিন্নম ধর্মস্য তত্ত্ব নিহিতম গুহায়ম মহাযোন মহাজন যেন গত সুপন্থ্যা। তর্ক অপতিষ্ঠ শ্রুতয়ো বিভিন্ন শ্রুতয়ো বিভিন্ন নাসৌ মুনির্যস্য মতম ন ভিন্নম ধর্মস্য তত্ত্বম নিহিতম গুহায়ম মহাযোন যেন গত সুপন্থ্যা। শিল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাদ টেলিং ইফ আওয়ার হোল লাইফ ইজ গন টু ফাইট উইথ মায়া দেন ওয়েন উই ক্যান স্টার্ট অ্যাকচুয়াল ভজন। শিল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাদ টেলিং ইফ আওয়ার হোল লাইফ ইজ গন টু ফাইট উইথ মায়া টু ফাইট উইথ অনর্থ দেন ওয়েন উই ক্যান স্টার্ট অ্যাকচুয়াল ভজন, দ্যাট ইজ দ্য মেন কোয়েশ্চন। দি আদার ডে আই ওয়াজ ডিসকাসিং অ্যাবাউট দিস পয়েন্ট, আই স্টার্টেড উইথ দিস word, the Prabhupada told, I got the highest association of my Guru Maharaj. I mean, I am getting the highest association, the excellent association of my Guru Maharaj. So I cannot think of any other association in my life. I am satisfied. Actually, we are put it into the ocean of Maya. Actually, we are put it into the ocean of Maya. And in Gita, Bhagavan already told, Mama Maya Durattaya Mami Bhoje Prapadyante Maya Metam Tarantite. Nobody can challenge that I can cut Maya very easily. Nobody can. Not even Shankar, not even Brahma. They are always expressing their humble attitude. We don't understand the actual mode of bhajan. What do you mean by bhajan? How to do bhajan? How to maintain pure association? All those are the important points in bhajan life. That day I was speaking about one incident, you know. One rich man coming daily Chaitanya Gaurimath, Calcutta. Anytime he coming, he finds Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj, Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj. He is speaking with somebody. One day he approached Maharaj and told Maharaj, when you are doing bhajan, whenever I come you are speaking. Maharaj with laughing mood, because Maharaj was number one preacher, Paramahansa Siddhar Goswami Maharaj and Madhava Goswami Maharaj. With appearance he can change your life. Darshane pavitra karo ei tamar gun. By acharan, Vaishnava advocacy acharan, he can change your life. He need not speak any harikatha to you, because his whole life is harikatha. What do you think? Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj cannot read Bhagavatam. Really so? Whole life of Bhagavatam, Srila Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj is the applied form of Bhagavatam. They are Bhagavatam. Granta Bhagavat, Book Bhagavat, and Bhakta Bhagavat. Bhakta Bhagavat is more important. Because Labamatya Sadhu Sangya Sarva Siddhi, I was discussing about this point. And everybody putting question before me, how to get rid of Maya? This is very dangerous. We cannot get out of Maya. And just now I started with the point, if we fight whole life with Maya, how to cut Maya out, then how we can start actual bhajan? First of all, I beg for pardon to you all because sometimes I become very harsh to speak the truth. But be sure about this point, I never speak anything which is not there in scripture, which is not spoken by any Guru Varga. Don't. So I beg for pardon to you. I can explain some point of Rasa Tattva, so then you cannot misunderstand me. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Srila Nanda Goswami Maharaj, what they are speaking, don't think there is flash. I can show you. Maybe you can misunderstand me, I know. But I can show you the link between them. Very nice link is there. This link, this understanding of proper adjustment among all our Guru Varga, this most important point, you see. I can explain some point, especially for you. Vikriritam Bhajapati Viridan Cha Vishnu, this slok, and what Sukhdev Goswami told. After that, I can explain everything. But today or tomorrow. Today my special point is, Prahlad Prabhu told, good association, this most important thing. After that I can try to, if time permits, by the grace of Guru Varga, I can try to explain Dhamma Tattva and Parikram, how to do Parikram, I can start. I told you that day, those who are the disciples of Srila Bhaktivedanta Vaman Goswami Maharaj, those are disciples of Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj, disciples of all those disciples of Srila Bhaktivalokitesvara Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhaktivedanta Bharati Maharaj, they are all my father and mother. Be sure 100%. I think I am regulated by you all. Because you are trying to control me, I mean save me in bhajan. As per the darshan of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. So everybody putting question before me, how to cut Maya? How to get rid of Sato Raja Tamo, three moods of nature, how to? Everybody putting question before me. But this is a very simple solution is there. You will have to hear Harikatha from a realized soul. Repeatedly I told you before. If I seek the path leading to the absolute good, then I must ignore the countless voices of popular wisdom and listen only to that of the realized soul that I told you. Because realization is most important thing. If I can inculcate some feeling into you, then my realization is responsible for that. I mean my acharan, my realization. Without realization, you cannot do bhajan. You cannot do bhajan. It's not possible actually. In Bhagavatam, see Supreme Lord, see Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving advice to Uddhava. If time permit, by the blessing of Guru Bhargava, I can try to explain so many points in front to get your blessing. Fully. Rajas tamascha satyena satyancha upasamena cha etat sarvam guru bhaktya puruso hi anjasayayet. Rajas tamascha satyena satyancha upasamena cha etat sarvam guru bhaktya puruso hi anjasayayet. Rajas tamascha satyena. Even I can try to explain Durga Tattva, Jogmaya. Devi is standing on lion and he is try to kill Asura and right hand side Ganesh, left hand side Ganesh and Kartik, I think. And Saraswati Lakshya, I can try to explain this, but not now. Rajas tamascha satyena satyancha pasamenecha etat sarvam guru bhaktya purushahi anjasayahit. Rajo tamo, you will have to defeat Rajo and Tamo by Satagun. You will have to defeat Rajo and Tamo by Satagun. But still, this Satagun is not pure Satagun. Anytime if I speak that he is a Satik, that doesn't mean he is pure Satik. Some admixture is there. I mean some portion, some percentage of Rajagun is there. Some percentage of Tamagun is there. But not 100% Sata. But I speak about Shuddha Vaishnava, about Prabhupada, Bhakti Vimala Purva Goswami, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. Then they are pure, they are established in pure Sata, because they are Nitya Parshad. And those who are Sadhan Siddha, they are also pure. So first of all, you will have to defeat Sato, Raja and Tamagun by Satagun. This is the strategy of Rajan field. You see, strategy is set by our Guru Bhargava. So you will have to defeat Raja and Tama. After that, you will have to defeat the Sata itself. Because if Sata is there, it can pull you to some other point, not to Bhakti. If you feel attraction for bhakti, then it is good. Pure devotion, not impure devotion. That is good. So, Rajo Tamo you must defeat by Sata, and Sata you must defeat by Rajas Tamo Satyena Satyancha Upasamena Cha. Upasam is Sanskrit word or Bengali word, you can see. Any Hindi you can. Upasam mean to remedy of your disease. So this is the one procedure. Your all etiquette acharan from early in the morning 3 o'clock or 2:30, you have to follow all rules and regulation of bhajan, not a matter of joke. You have to follow your Guru Patpadma in toto. And you should not have any doubt about Vaishnava Tattva and Guru Tattva. If you have any doubt about Vaishnava Tattva and Guru Tattva, if you have doubt about scriptural analysis, then you are not going to do bhajan. You cannot come out successful. Because in Gita, Bhagavan repeatedly speaking, your doubt can throw you into material ocean. Your doubt, if you have any doubt, then you cannot come out successfully in this life. Maybe you have growing proficiency to speak Harikatha, this, that. But if you have any doubt, that doubt can throw you into material ocean, again you will have to take bath, again you have to do bhajan. Be careful. There is so analytical point in bhajan. Nobody likes to discuss this. Very important. So, Satyancha Pasamenecha. Satyancha means still. Sato, that Sato should be defeated by Upasamenecha. Upasam means some procedure to get remedy, a material disease. Etat sarvam. All these vital point. Because in scripture we find so many barriers there, impediments in bhajan. In Gita, in Bhagavad, Bhagavan Sri Krishna, I mean explaining this point to Uddhav. Even when you are trying to do excellent bhajan, you are trying to get rid of maya, 80% maya gone, 90% gone,
Still, those demigods, they like to put pressure on me. Crash! Well, he is going to pass our abode. Like to go to Supreme Lord, Vaikuntha? Oh, we won't allow him. We can throw. Even those who are taking sannyasis, maximum of them, they have fall down. Why? Because they don't know, actually. I already write one book, actually compile one book of what do you mean by sannyas, approved by Prabhupada. But nobody likes to read, because if they read, they cannot run fancifully. They cannot lead their life fancifully. Even those grihastha life is very good. They are leading life very controlled way. I am very happy. So, Bhagavan Sri Krishna explained to Uddhava, those demigods, they don't allow anybody to pass them away and go to. Understand? Even after Brahmalok, Brahma staying, Brahma's abode, you have to pass away and go to Viraja. Viraja, infinity water, transcendental water. You will have to purify yourself. Like you go to Ganga and take bath to get purified. If at all any Rajatama particle is there with your body and fine body, then you will have to take bath in Viraja. Viraja means Vigato Raja. Yeah, clear. Make him. After that Vigato Raja, after taking bath in Viraja, you can go out. Where to go? How to go? Sadashiv Lok, after that, I can explain this point after. So, etat sarvam guru bhaktya. You all are fed up with this point, how to get rid of Maya. But Bhagavan Sri Krishna is very easy, very easy. How to cut Maya? How to cut Maya? It's written, Krishna Bhagavan speaking, but you are busy with this point. Etat sarvam guru bhaktya. Etat sarvam guru guru bhaktya. Guru bhaktya purushohi anjasa jayet. Guru bhakta means in Sanskrit, those who are reading Sanskrit, those who are pandit. Pandit means those who are actually practicing acharya. They are pandit. Memorizing the Vyakaran, this, that. Shankaracharya speaking, if you are memorizing Vyakaran, what use of it? I can explain this point. How Shankaracharya is laughing. You are knowing so many Vyakaran, this, that, Sanskrit grammar. We're useless. It's no use, you see. So, etat sarvam guru bhaktya. Guru bhakti. Guru bhaktya. Guru means saptami. Guru bhaktya. Guru te. Guru me bhakti. Etat sarvam guru bhaktya purusehi anjasajet. Now, just I told, you should not confuse between Guru Tattva and Vaishnava Tattva. Most important, because some kind of politics can come into your heart. This Vaishnava Tattva. Don't make that. Sangsayatma vinashvati. In Gita, Bhagavan saying, Arjun, my friend, Sangsayatma vinashvati. Those who are having some doubt about Vaishnava Tattva, Guru Tattva, Dhamma Tattva, Nama Tattva, any doubt, then you will have to come back again. No way out. Be careful. Slow but steady and win the race. Slow but steady and win the race. You can win the race, no problem. But you have to believe on Guru Vaishnava, 100%. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, who is Vaishnava? He is Guru. Who is Guru? He is Vaishnava. There is no doubt. Guru Tattva is Akhanda Tattva. Repeatedly I told, many Harikatha I told, different places. Guru Tattva and Vaishnava Tattva same. Akhanda Tattva, unbreakable, unique and single Tattva. It is manifested in different form, maybe. Manifested into development, you can. And each of our Guru Bhargava, they can have some sort of speciality. That is no point. Maybe. Paramahansa Bhakti Vedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj, he has some speciality. Srila Bhakti Purna Purga has some speciality. Paramahansa Siddhar Goswami has some speciality. Bhakti Vedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Bhagavan Kesava Goswami Maharaj, they have some speciality. But maybe they have some speciality. But speciality mean, doesn't mean that they approve our fighting in between. We cannot fight. They cannot speciality, but I can show the link. Link in between them. That's it. So who is Vaishnava? Is Guru. His Guru is Vaishnava. They should not. Sankshayatma Vinashvati. So Guru Bhakti doesn't mean that I have taken Diksha from this Guru, so I will have to do Bhakti. Yes, right. You will have to do Bhakti, exclusive Bhakti. Special. Because you grow your sense of relationship from this manifestation of Balaram. Balaram manifests in the form of my Guru. I got the sense of relationship. I mean, Samadha Tattva I got from Guru Pad. So, some special point is there. But Vrindavan, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami is speaking, je Shikha Guru and Diksha Guru all same. Prabhupada also explaining. From Diksha Guru you are developing Samandagan Tattva. And from Shikha Guru you are developing Avidyagan Tattva. And maybe sometime my Diksha Guru is Shikha Guru itself. Like in case of me. I got all Shiksha, Diksha, Harinam, base. I'm really lucky. Or still I'm not lucky. Because I could not catch the actual theme of my Guru Maharaj. So I'm not lucky. But still I'm lucky because I got everything from Guru Maharaj. Everything. Harinam, Diksha, base, Brahmacharya, red cloth, white cloth, everything all by Guru Maharaj. Even teaching, how to edit books, all Guru Maharaj in the world. But still, I think Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj is my Sikhya Guru. Srila Bhakti Vallabh Chittu Goswami Maharaj, Sikhya Guru. Nayan Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, they are all my Sikhya. I cannot avoid them. Not possible. This way, etat sarvam guru bhakta purusehi anjusajayat. So now you get one solid point, how to conquer Maya. You get? Bandhamui savadhano mate. We sing. Bhaktisiddhanta Babaji Maharaj, they are Paramahansa Sreshta. He used to speak. In Dakai language, you know, Bangal Bhasha. Tumi to gaiyai gela. Jar phatlo, tar phatlo. Bangal Bhasha. Bangal, mane crude Bengali language from Dhaka. So nice, those who are Bengali people, they are laughing. Tumi to gaiyai gela. Jar phatlo, tar phatlo. You couldn't get the actual feeling of that song. So you are only singing. But I am feeling pain in my heart. So Bandhamui Sabdhan Mate. We must worship Guru Bhat Padma Vaishnava, but be very carefully. There should not be any mistake. So to get pure association, first of all, to purify myself, I need pure association. To go with my bhajan, I need pure association. After leaving my body, I need pure association. Everywhere, pure association, sadhu sangha, sadhu sangha, sarva satya kai. Lava matra sadhu sangha. Sarva siddhi, I mean, even you can get Krishna prema, which is the ultimate goal of bhajan. But that sadhu sangha can be. Bhakti Vinod Thakur explaining how to get. Suppose one sadhu, he has very nice feeling inside his heart. How I can get that feeling? It's possible. I can give big pranami to him. He can give feeling? No, not that actually. How I can get that feeling? Bhaktivinoda Thakur is planning. You have seen clouds? At the time of rainy season, different pieces of cloud coming in contact.
and they become sound because of exchange of ion. And as per chemistry, positive and negative ion, they get balanced. Because the different kind of potentiality is there of charge in this piece of cloud, this they come in contact, suddenly they get balanced and then the boom, one sound. And lightning. Any lightning? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking very nice way. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, when two clouds coming in contact of each other, then because of exchange of ion, there you can feel, hear some sound. At the same time, lightning is there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur explaining, if you are coming in contact with a pure Vaishnava, really, from heart, not physical, from heart you will have to approach Vaishnava. Because their heart is so clear, if you come in front of them, some your picture is there. They can get some picture of your heart. Like in border place, there is some radar. If a fighting plane coming, oh, radar speaking, some plane coming. They can feel. So, first of all, you should approach Guru Vaishnava with very clean heart. Or even some dirty heart is there, but still there should be saralata, simplicity. Saralata in Bengali. What do you mean by saralata? Saralata means straightness, simplicity. Some foolish people is there, somebody speaking, Maharaj, he is very saral. You say, foolish you are. He is not saral. It seems he is foolish. He is foolish. Foolish, foolishness, foolish, he is foolish. He is not saral. Saral is different term. Saral means when your inside and outside is in matter is there in straight line. Your inside and outside matter, content and straight line. Like straight line in mathematics, if this line is passing through this point, it must satisfy this point. Parabolic, hyperbolic, if you are doing mathematics, you can understand. So it's automatically. Mathematics say it must satisfy this point. Economics, you can, demand and supply graph, you can see. So this way, there should not be any complication into your heart. I mean straightness. This is called simplicity. If there is some dirty thing in your heart, but you want to become pure, Guru Vaishnava can bless you, you can clean your heart very easily. Because satsanga is most important. In the light of Bhagavatam, or more clearly I can speak in the light of Srimad Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teaching, on those days, coming days, I can try to explain this point. Bhagavatam, if I don't go through the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then useless. Useless point. No use. So you see, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that if you come in contact with a pure Vaishnava who has a very nice feeling, maybe Brajabhav or maybe, how to get? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if you are coming in contact with the pure bosom from heart, then day by day you can have the chance to do some seva. When your mind is totally engaged in seva, Vaishnava seva, Guru Vaishnava seva, totally. You are trying now, but today or tomorrow you can find whole mind engaged in Guru Vaishnava seva. Psychiatrists, those who are doctors, psychiatrist doctor, they're speaking, the scientists, they are speaking, the mind can never go vacant. Mind can never go vacant. You cannot, like in science you find some space is giving to you, you can cover it, you try to make it totally airless, not possible. Some year must be there. Totally vacant is not possible. So you can try to purify your mind. Like you see, in darkness, if you put one light, I mean beam of light, even sunlight when coming through one hole, you can find so countless dust particles there. A beam of light, you can find countless dust particles there. Air suspension, even water suspension also there. You try to get aqua guard, apply to get pure water. Suspension is there. And if you look at galaxy way, I mean space, there is also suspension, because star and different, countless stars and there, sun, moon, these, that, so many suspension there. Even your mind, there is suspension of matters. Yes. You can try to meditate on Guru Pātva, but you can find you are going to Bombay, you are going to this, there. You are going here and there. You cannot, not possible. 100% possible, not possible. But today or tomorrow, if your effort is sincere effort, if you put sincere effort, then today or tomorrow you can find you are successful. So, in your mind some suspension is there. Those are circuits is there speaking. That suppose I can see everything, material thing. In Dhamma nothing material, I see all car going, trees, a woman, these that I can see. But if I try to prove that I am yogi, see I am meditating so nicely in a lonely place. Prabhupada speaking, as per Gita you are a liar. Mitha charo sauchate. If I try to concentrate my mind, in a solitary place if I go, Krishna speaking, there is no remedy, no solution. Because suspension is there, matter is there inside your mind. You try to eliminate matters outwardly. Externally you try to get rid of matters, but you cannot get rid of matter, because matter is there inside your suspension. Like water suspension, yes, suspension. So how you can get rid? So Prabhupada speaking, doing Sankirtan, it is called meditation. Repeatedly I explain this point. Sankirtan is the best way to get rid of Maya. But that even Jagadananda Pandito, Sadhu Sange Krishna Nam Ei Marto Chai Sangsar Dinite Ar Kono Vastu Nai. Sadhu Sange Krishna Nam. Sadhu Sange Krishna Nam. With Sadhu, I must say, different sloka there in Bhagavatam, I can explain. Brahma speaking in 10th canto, you can see. Sanmukhuritam bhavadiya vartam. A previous point, sthanis hitaha sutigatam tanuvang manuvhir. Brahma speaking. When Brahma getting one feedback, then Brahma appealing to Krishna, Gopal, Govind. Sthanis thitas, tanuvang manuvhir. Kai man bhakha. Kai, body, mind and speech. Your body, mind and speech. Sriti. So this way, Kaimana Bhaksha, Brahma speaking, je sthanes sitaha sutibang manovir. Sthanes sitaha mean Vishwanath Chakravarti was explaining, Brahma speaking, sthanis sthitaha. What do you mean by sthanis sthitaha? Vishwanath Chakravarti was explaining, to stay in front of Guru Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava. Where you have the chance, 100% chance to hear Harikatha all the time. Sthanis sthitaha. I like to put myself in a proper position, proper place, where I have the chance to hear transcendental Harikatha all the time. Many sloka there. Sutekshito patanonunatha pungsham. This sloka I can explain. You will have to depend on Sautapantha. You will have to depend on Sautapantha. Not that you can memorize and speak a lot. What I heard from Guru Varga, and if I read by the order of Guru Vaishnava, if I read some Shastra, I can tally, I can get some harmony. Then and only. Guru Mukha Padma Bhakya Hidayat Kariya Aikya Arna Kariya Manyasa. There should not be any desire. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if you come in contact with the pure Vaishnava, if you go on doing seva very carefully, very sincerely, because sometime some of our Guru Varga, they are taking permission from Prabhupada Bhakti that time. From Prabhupada, please permit that we are going to get take darshan of the lotus feet of Gaur Kishore Das Bhaiya. Don't go! Why? We have to see Guru Vaishnava. Don't go. You cannot understand his mood. You can misunderstand him. You can go to hell. Better you don't go. It depends upon my speech. Maybe it is hard for you. But still you hear this point. Then you can understand Guru Tattva and Vaishnava Tattva. Otherwise not possible. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, day by day if you serve a pure Vaishnava very sincerely, and by chance he is giving full kippah to you, then automatically his heart, like I can give example from Chaitanya Charitamrita, Chaitanya Bhagavat. Ishwar Paribad getting full kippa of Madhavendra Paribad. I heard somewhere somebody speaking that day by day we are losing power because we cannot maintain the power of Guru Varga. I told him, he is foolish, he is explaining in Vrindavan. I wanted to speak, I thought he is foolish, I shouldn't speak anything. If I cannot have that kind of strong feeling, I can get full power of my Guru Maharaj, then how I can do bhajan? How my Guru Parampara can be maintained? Then you, as per your version, you want to prove that gradually degradation of Guru Varga, I mean power, degradation of power coming on. So who is going to do bhajan then? They cannot. It's very dangerous. So you must believe 100% that I can get, though I am not qualified, but today or tomorrow I must do bhajan in such a way, by the guidance of my Guru Bhara, I am going to get the full power of Bhakti Pranathpuri Goswami Maharaj. And Bhakti Pranathpuri Goswami Maharaj, he was successful to get full. I mean, they are Nitya Parsad of Prabhupada. Then you can maintain parampara. Otherwise, parampara, day by day you are losing power. Who is going to believe? Is Guru? Guru means Guru. This is important point, you see. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if that Paramahansa Guru Padma Vaishnava is very, very satisfied with you, he can inculcate his feeling inside your heart. You can go to market and buy Ujjal Minmani, this, that, but it's no point. In Vrindavan, some Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj are there. Somebody came and informed me, your disciple reading Ujjal Minmani. Oh, really? Call him to me, before me. Babaji Maharaj become there. I heard you are reading. You will have to go for fasting every alternative day, because your sense organ is very dirty. You cannot get control over your sense organ. And if you are failure to get control of your sense organ, how you can hear about? And in Bhagavatam, I can explain this point. How Prabhupada explained, Bhaktivinoda Thakura explained. Kesava Goswami, I can explain. Vikritam Parivodhi Viridhan Chivishnu Sadhyan Nitam Manusranivada Thavarana Yajya. Huh? I can explain this way, very scientifically. Then you can realize. And you cannot understand the heart of your Guru Parva. Never misunderstand me. You are all my father and mother. If you misunderstand, I can die. Suppose my mother today cooking very nice thing. So many prasadam preparing. So many fry, pushpanna, paramanna, so many. She like to give me prasadam. At the time of taking prasadam, I will have to become very alert, very careful. Mother giving me forcefully, you will have to take. See, mother, prasadam you are serving, but liver is mine. My liver. So I will have to think about that, my digestion power. You are loving me. You can give me. But I cannot digest. Then what happens? I will have to go to doctor. Then what happens? You are cooking so, you are giving so much energy to prepare so many prasadam. Huh? So I will have to be very careful about when you are serving me. You can watch anywhere. Yeah, about my prasadam taking. Nobody can see where, how I am taking prasadam. Very secretly I take prasadam. But very careful. Though I like this prasadam, it's very nice. Which is very nice prasadam, very excellent, tasty. But because Suddha Guru Vaishnava, they think every, all prasadam tasty. Not that Paramananda is tasty, not that. But which, as for your opinion, if it is very tasty, then you can find Guru Vaishnava taking a little bit, punch. Oh, very nice. Then leave it for you all. Don't take it. It's nice prasadam, so I can take a lot. Not that. So this way you should not misunderstand me. So I told you just now, bandhamui sabdhan mate. Mane, if you do pure association very carefully, then it is very easy for you. I started with this point. What point? Tarko apatishtho. Logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. This most important point. In Mahabharata, this point is there. Tarko apatishtho. Sutayo vivinna. Naso muni rajasa matam navinyam. Mahajano jeno gato sapantya. Just a few minutes ago I explained, all our Guru Varga, they can have some speciality. But I should try to find harmony. So torko, logical interpretation going on among different pandit. Torko apatishtho. Torko cannot come out successful ultimately. Many slokas, different ways, in third canto, these, there. Very nice slokas. You can go mad. So nice. There you can find. Those who are interested to fight with Guru Vaishnava, misunderstand Guru Vaishnava, they cannot come out successful. Now, I like to give some example from Chaitanya Charitamrita. I mean the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, Krishna Bhagavan advised to Uddhava, it is very easy to get control over Maya, just now I told. So, only the thing you will have to do, go for pure association. Etat sarvam guru bhaktya purusohi anjosa jayet, very easily. You can cut Maya. Three modes of nature cannot put any pressure on you. But provided you are doing pure seva, nice seva. So before doing pure seva, you will have to be pure. Now question coming, if I am pure, then why should I go to the iskam question? Now, come on, that day I explained, when you are speaking Harinam, you have the chance to hear, you have the chance to think about Harinam, Similarly, when you are hearing from Guru Bhargava, you have chance to think about that Harikatha, transcendental world. It is inconceivable, I know. But still, you are doing seva, seva, then today or tomorrow, all your like tamra bhavati kanchana, tamra. I mean, copper can be converted into gold. If I mix some chemical, by some chemical reaction, the copper or iron can be converted into gold. I give you example, nice example. Very nice example. So many examples, I like to discuss this point whole month, 1 month. One example I give you, very excellent one. Namacharya Haridas Thakur. Namacharya Haridas Thakur, personal associate of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is doing 3 lakhs Harinam. That day that scholar put a question before me. 3 lakhs Haridas Thakur doing chanting loudly, 3 lakhs mentally, 1 lakh mentally, 1 lakh opangshu, tongue dancing. So I already give evidence from Shastra. Harinam aparam japyam dhyam gyam nirantaram. Everything possible. But if you speak loudly, pure Vaishnava when speaking loudly, then those sthavar jangam, those who are living creatures or those matter, they have the chance to hear the transcendental thought vibration. This is the facility. Understand? So Namacharya Haridas Thakur, his position is excellent position. He is doing Harinam all the time. So in Benapol, one place there near Bangladesh border, Benapol, there Haridas Thakur started doing Nambhajan very carefully. Tulsi pot putting in front of Harinam place, Bhajan Kuchir, and doing Harinam very carefully. But the Ramchandra Khan, he became very envious with him, because everybody coming to pay dandavat to Haridas Thakur, because Pratishtha, Vaishnava, those who are pure Vaishnava, they are not at all interested to get Pratishtha. But automatically Pratishtha coming to them. Patishtar sabhav e jaina chaye tar hai vidhata nirmito. I can explain this point from Chaitanya. When I can explain? Life is very short. I always speak lie in front of you. I can explain. I can try. Patishtar sabhav e jaina chaye tar hai vidhata nirmito. Their Pratishtha, Prabhupada explained. Who is Vaishnava? Prabhupada explained. Vaishnavi patishtha tate kara nishtha tahana karile labhibe raurav. Vaishnavi patishtha, you must accept Vaishnavi patishtha. Someday Prabhupada explain, you all worshipping me, Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta, you all worshipping me, I am sitting in the chair of Acharya Gurudev. Is it true? I am taking you are worshipping me, I am accepting it. Be sure, 100%, I am not accepting your worship. You are worshipping me, everybody looking. But you are not worshipping me, you are worshipping my Guru Prabhupada. This way Guru Bhargava never take any Pratishtha. That is called Vaishnavi Pratishtha. Vaishnavi Pratishtha, seemingly it is coming in my life, but I already transferred this Pratishtha to Radharani or Nityananda Prabhu. First I speak Nityananda Prabhu. And nothing touching me. Because otherwise that Pratishtha can kill me. Pratishtha sadhrishtha sapataramani merdinatet. Raghunath Goswami speaking. Pratishtha sadhi is like a very first lady. Patishtas Adhishta, Sapacharamani. Those who are cooking the meat of, I mean, dog, even from that caste, one very low-grade woman coming, pros. Raghunath Goswami, comparing this point with this Patishtata. So, Kanoka Kamini Pratishtaga Bhagini Chariya Che Jare Sevto Vaishnava. Many points there, if you like to clarify this point. How you can understand his Vaishnava? He can give nice lecture, but you can follow. Kanoka Kamini Pratishtha Bhagini Chariya Che Jare Sevto Vaishnava. Kanoka Kamini means like Hiranyakasipu. Hiranyakasipu? Hiranya means Kamana Kanaka Kamini. Kasipu means bed, woman, actually. It's very secret points there. So you see, Kanaka Kamini, Patishta Bhagini, Chariya Chariya Saida. He is 100% Vaishnava. He never cares about your Pratishta. He is always ready to speak the absolute truth. You should follow this point. Now, point is that, Prabhupada speaking, I never accept any Pratishtha you are giving. So all Pratishtha I give to my Guru Bhargava. So Haridas Thakur, you see, similar thing, all our Guru Bhargava. All our Guru Bhargava, you see. Haridas Thakur doing bhajan. Everybody paid endeavor to Haridas Thakur. But the Ramchandra is very envious with him. He liked to fight. He liked to kill Haridas. He liked to prove that Haridas Thakur is a fallen soul in front of people, all, so that nobody can go to pay respect to him anymore. Huh? That is the target of Anjali. Understand? So he is trying accordingly. He sent one nice frost, very beautiful frost, to Haridas Thakur at the night time. Haridas Thakur doing Harinam. He is exhibiting some sort of pose so that he, nobody can keep patience. Patience, this point is very important. Patience can ultimately give you success. Dharya. It's very big point. Very big point, important point in your life. Dharya. Like Ajamil point A, discuss, Ajamil lose his patience. That's why he couldn't come out successful. Ajamil was very nice, Brahman. No, come on, he's nice. But his satsanga was not sufficient. His satsanga was not sufficient. That's why we fall down. If your satsanga is 100% perfect, many times your Guru Padma explain this point. I also speak. Kam krodh sadhu kere ki korite pare, jodi hoy sadhu janar sango. Kama krodha, what they can do harm to you if you are doing actual sadhu sanga. Bharti Maharaj always explain this point. Narottama Thakur. This point is written by Narottama Thakur. Sing. Kam krodh sadhu kere ki korite pare, jodi hoy sadhu janar sango. If you are going for pure association, what kama and krodha can do harm to you? What harm? Eh? No, you cannot do anything. So, Haridas Thakur doing Harinam, she is coming. At least they pay dandava to Tulsi and paying dandava to Hari. That is positive point. First day he got some positive point. He paid dandava to Tulsi. Yeah, and Tulsi, if you pay dandava to Tulsi, if you touch Tulsi, if you get the smell of Tulsi, if you look Tulsi, all giving bhakti. He paid dandava to Tulsi and Haridas Thakur, his pure Vaishnava. First day he got some positive point. Haridas Thakur blessing him. Okay, I know. But you will have to wait. Because I am always Diksha, I already got Diksha in Harinam. So until and unless I finish my Harinam Diksha, I mean I already, every day I get Diksha in Harinam. Today I will have to do this Harinam. So until and unless I finish my Harinam, I cannot satisfy you. Satisfy you mean? Satisfy your heart, pure soul. Haridasa is speaking the truth, but she cannot understand. She cannot understand, speaking the truth. I can satisfy you. I mean, I can satisfy your pure soul. That is there inside you. But you have to wait for that. Okay. Whole night gone. That process, then morning time gone. Second, next day, she coming to for making disturbance. Same thing happens. Paying dandavat to Tulsi and Haridas, sitting. He tried to break the resolution of Haridas Thakur. Who can do? She cannot do. Haridas Thakur. Harinam. Then in the morning day, she feels disgusted. Well, every day you are doing Harinam, Harinam, Harinam. You are speaking, promising me. Huh? But you cannot complete your Harinam. She feels disgusted. God. Well, what I can do? I take resolution every day, so I cannot break. Okay. Next day you come, I can say. Consecutively for 3 days, she is hearing Harinam from the lotus mouth of Haridas Thakur. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So, that process, ultimately in the morning time, she is crying, she is expressing the truth, that naughty, you see, that is a bad guy, on him, Ramchandra Gavira, he is sending me to you to break your resolution. Please, Haridas Thakur is smiling, thinking, I know it before, that's why I'm waiting, keeping patience. I know it before. To deliver you, I am waiting. To deliver you, I am waiting. Now, for consecutively about 3 days, she is looking Haridas, hearing Haridas. So, darshane pavitra karo ei tomar gun. Totally, her mind changed. She become great devotee now. You show me the way, my Gurudev. You show me the way. I am fallen, so go, take bath. And distribute all the wealth. You collect all wealth by dirty means. You go and give it to Brahman, Vaishnava, here, there, in all temples. You distribute. Don't keep even a single penny for your personal protection. Go. He distributes. See, distribute. And with one white cloth, coming to Haridas. Now you save me? Well, sit. Give Tulsi Mala to her. Now you wear. And give Harinam. After giving Harinam, Haridas Thakur explaining what you mean by Harinam. You will have to explain Harinam. If somebody giving Harinam to you, it is the procedure to explain what you mean by Harinam. By Harinam, you can find your link with Krishna. Otherwise, your taking Harinam is not. Your procedure is this. You can discover your relationship with Krishna. What do you mean by Harinam? Big past chapter, you see. Bhaktivinoda Thakur explaining about Harinam in Jorasako, the house of Rabindranath Thakur and Dijananath Thakur. Prince Daraganath Thakur, their house is there in North Calcutta. Rabindranath Tagore, their house. Bhaktivinoda Thakur explaining Harinam that time. About Harinam. In front of hundreds of people. Harinam. What do you mean by Harinam? Explaining this point. So Haridas Thakur, see, the mood of Haridas Thakur. Same thing Prabhupada speaking. To deliver a fallen soul, we must spend gallons of gallon of blood. But still there is no guarantee that I can save this bonded soul. Because bonded soul can run fancifully. Until and unless that bonded soul is 100% inclined to me, I cannot deliver. of or he is 50% inclined at the time of diksha. Actually, it is a rule. At the time of diksha, you should have 100% submission. At the time of diksha, it is a procedure of diksha. At the time of diksha, your 100% submission should satisfy unto a lotus feet of Guru Pada. But usually, it is seen at the time of diksha, somebody 50% inclination, somebody 60%, somebody 70%. But if 100% inclination is satisfied at the time of your diksha, then instantly you can get the feelings of Guru. But he is not. Because Kripa is flowing downwards. Kripa always flowing downward. Kripa. If your pot is perfect, then Kripa can come from Guru Padma. But you are not inclined. In time, your pot should be there. Down at the lotus feet of just near the lotus feet of Guru Padma, then you can get Kripa. So you see the quality of Haridas Thakur. Mahaprabhu speaking, nobody can chant Haridam. Haridas Thakur is a great personality. He is the Nama Acharya. He is the Acharya of Nama. Many foreign people used to put question before me at the time of Guru Maharaj. Where we are giving Dhamma Kippa, Nama Kippa, Prasadam Kippa, Vaishnava, we are hearing Harikatha from Vaishnava. Then why we are not giving Kippa? Because of that thing? You are not getting pure association? Or maybe you have the chance to get pure association, you don't know the procedure how to get. So pure association can clean your heart. Though you are in Bondestol, you have to go for pure association. Then go on doing association. After that, you can clean your heart. Then you can get the actual taste of pure association. Understand? Bonded in bonded state, like that. Who name? His name? Lokhira, the pros. See. She went to Haridas, but that time her heart was dirty. So it's okay. Dirty heart, okay. But still she is approaching Haridas. But last day, she approached Haridas 100% perfect. First she came with very dirty mood. Second day also with dirty mood. But third day after hearing Harinam. So what procedure you discover? You will have to do serve Guru Vaishnava, but at the same time you will have to hear Harikatha from them. This procedure we discuss. If Harikatha and Seva are not going parallel, today or tomorrow you can discover that your Guru Patpanda is a material person. You can discover. You can think. Discover me, you can think. Not that. So very vital point. Very, very 100% vital point. So Harikatha and Seva should go parallel. That can help you. Many such cases I can show you. Those who are doing the Seva of Guru Vaishnava. They are staying just near Guru Vaishnava. Not mentally, physically. But gradually they are doing aparad. After that they fall down. I like to give one or two examples, you see. One day, Gaurakishordas Babaji Maharaj in Kolodip there, in Rani Chara, in Vajan Kutir, one day, Gaurakishordas Babaji Maharaj was shouting, "Last night I am searching you to save up. Last night I am calling you, where you are? Last night I was searching for you, I am calling you." The sevak, he is fighting with Gurudev. "Why? I was here? You were here? But I am calling you so many times. I am here?" "Oh, really? So, okay." Next day, Gaurakishordas Babaji Maharaj exhibit this kind of lilas. He cannot see properly. His eyesight is not proper. He is going to his bed. He search. That devotee is not there. Again, next They? Gaur Kishore Babaji must be. Where you are? I don't find you there. Well, I was there. You are here. I don't find you. I don't find you there. I was there in my bed. I search your bed. I don't find you there. After that, Gaur Kishore Babaji was very angry. Why you speak lie for this cheap gratification? You are running for self-gratification, I know. But you are doing night time, I know. Why? Why you speak lie? You can speak very clearly to me. So, Prabhupada explained this point. Many bonded soul, they try to exhibit that I am staying with this pure devotee. I am always staying with this pure devotee, you see. But they are not actually staying with pure devotee. They like to get some name and fame, position. Because if somebody can understand that I am doing seva of this pure devotee, they can pay respect to me, give money, kamini-kanji easily I can get. So this is very easy procedure of business. It's very cheap, very without capital I can do business. Because in each business you need investment. But this business without investment I can do business. So nice. So Gaur Kishore Babaji was very, very, very angry. So if you like to stay with Guru Vaishnava, you should stay mentally from heart. You should try to get the association of pure Vaishnava. Many examples I can show from the history of Saraswat Gauriya Parivar family, within the family of our Saraswat Gauriya. Many devotees, not one, I can. But I am not going to criticize them. They wanted to see, do the seva of pure Vaishnava and they fall down. Because they never tried to get the help of Bani. That's why they fall down. That's why they fall down. So for pure association, first you will have to keep your ear open. Your oral reception should be perfect. Go on hearing Harikatha and try to do seva, try to do Harinam. And if you try to do actual bhajan, then I will have to explain Sikkhashtakak Upadeshamrita Manasikha. If I fail to explain this Manasiksha, Sikkhashtakam and Upadeshamritam, I have no right to chide you. Hey! Why you are not doing bhajan? I have no right to chide you. As a Guru Padma, Vaishnava, their first duty to explain Manasiksha, explain Upadeshamrita, and Sikkhashtakam by the guidance of Prabhupada. And Keshav Goswami Mahabhav explained this way. And Jaiva Dharma is a must. Repeatedly I told Jagadananda Prem Vibharto. Maybe it is translated into English. You must read it repeatedly. And if you advise somebody, you can advise from this Jagadananda Prem Vibharto. But it can give quick result. So force is there. So power is there inside. Jagadananda Prem Vibharto. That day I already quoted one point. Jodi pranay rakhite chao gaurangir shane, choto haridasar kotha thaki jannamane. If you like to maintain a nice, sweet relationship with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you must remember the teachings of Haridas Thakur. Now I can go back to Bhagavatam, Kapil Dev and Devahuti Sambad. There you can find Devahuti. I can explain so many, I can try to explain from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Charitamrita, Bhagavatam, from different sastra. There we find Devahuti mother crying. She's crying. She's crying. In front of his son, Supreme Lord, son, Supreme Lord.
And at the last moment, she is saying, you are not my son. You are coming in front of me as my son. But actually, you are Supreme Lord. I know. Kapilji in front of me. And Kapilji giving nice advice to Devahuti at the bank of Bindu Sarovar. Bindu Sarovar in west, northwest. Bindu Sarovar. Nice place. Bindu Sarovar. There she is doing bhajan. She got nice advice from Kapilji. And Kapilji giving advice to Matai. Sango jo sangsiter heto asasya vihito dhiya sa eva sadusu kritaha nishangataya kalpate. Or sometimes I speak two sloka, I combine, I speak nicer. Sango yo sangsite heto sasso vihito diya sa eva sadusu kritaha mokshadaram apavritam. It is not grammatically mistake. One sloka, same chapter. But it's very clear to understand. Sango yo sangsite heto. Because association is a must. You cannot put guarantee in front of me, Maharaj, I cannot go for any association anymore from today, I give. No! Association is a must. Many times I try to explain, by the blessing of Guru Bhargava, explain this point. Until and unless one Gurupat Padma, who is acting as Acharya, until and unless he is established in Adhyaya Gyan Tattva, then 100% he cannot avoid evil association. Somehow evil association. By cooking, I mean somebody cooking, his heart is not good, he is giving, is contaminated. Don't fight with this point. Don't fight. But I am speaking the truth, scientific point. So this point is very important. This point is, but those who are tejiyasam na dosaya banhel sarva uya jatha, those who are powerful Vaishnav, for them it is not dangerous. But those who are acting as acharya, not completely established in Adhyaya Gyan Tattva, anywhere you look, you find everything is Krishna. You cannot find any pretty girl, you cannot find any handsome boy, not possible. Everything you look, anywhere you look, Adhyaya Gyan Tattva. Nothing you can find without Krishna. Other than Krishna, you cannot see anything. That is the position of one pure devotee. Adhyaya Gyan Tattva. 100% you will have to get established in Adhyaya Gyan Tattva. Even Prabhupada speaking, those who are going for preaching, they should not go for preaching if they are not established in Adhyaya Gyan Tattva. Because there they can buy some evil association in their life and go to hell. And with pure Vaishnava, if some Madhyam Adhikari going with pure Vaishnava, if they can maintain their life properly, if they are staying under the guidance of Guru Bhargava, pure Vaishnava, he is going for preaching, then okay. Madhyam Adhikari, excellent condition, still he can go for preaching. Madhyam Adhikari can preach. Those who are pure devotee, Paramahansa, they cannot preach. Their life is itself there, manifested in front of you. But still, our Guru Varga, Srila Bhakti Mohan Puri Goswami Maharaj, Paramikesha Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti, they are all, Bhakti Siddhar, they are all Paramahansa actually. But purposely, they come down to the second level. They come down means they exhibit. They cannot come down, they are excellent level. They show as if they are in Madhyam Adhikari, because Madhyam Adhikari can preach. Understand?
Then you, now you can point, but I express some doubt. Why? Why? Tulsidas ji speaking nice sloka. Very nice. Sadguru mele bhed batave, gyan kare upadesh. Kaila ka maila chute jab aankh kare pravesh. Very nice sloka. Tulsidas ji speaking. Tulsidas. Sadguru mele bhed batave, gyan kare upadesh. Kaila ka maila chute jab aankh kare pravesh. Very nice in Hindi. I like to explain this. Sadguru mile, by chance, I mean, by your sukriti accumulated, birth after birth. Satsanga prapate pambhir, bhuvir sukriti purva sanchitai. Now you are getting bumper success to get good association. Now, point is that, Tulsidas is speaking, Sadguru mile. Suppose you are getting a nice, pure devotee, Sadguru. Ved batame. Ved mean? Ved batame mean? Distinction between matter and spiritual thing. This is matter. Come on, my son. This is material thing. This is pure spiritual thing. Don't mix it. If you like, if you try to lead your life this way, then you can come out successful. Understand? Bhakti pat iho kantaka koti ruddho ha ha ka jami bi kim aham karomi. This sloka I can explain someday. So many sloka coming in my heart by your blessing. So you see, there, what happens? Tulsidas ji speaking, suppose you are getting good association, Sadguru mele. Now, it is your duty to submit 100% unto it. And it is the duty of Guru Padma to show you the distinction, the difference between matter and spiritual thing. First, he can inculcate into your heart the actual feeling. Anything you say, you cannot think. Dwarship. You should cut this feeling, false ego of dwarship. Kottitto. If you can cut this, then you can develop patience. Otherwise not. When your dwarship is totally finished from your heart, then and only then you can develop this quality of patience. You can find my life is totally regulated by Supreme Divinity. You can see this world like dream. In dream, you see, sometime in dream you can see so many things. Those who are Paramahansa, they see this, look this world like dream. They look this world like dream. You see. So what happens? Tulsidas ji explaining. Tulsidas ji now explaining, Sadguru mere ved batave, gyan kare upadesh. Now, Paramahansa Guru Pad Padma, pure Guru Pad, pure devotee, he is now going to advise me about absolute tattva. Sadguru mele ved batave, gyan kare upadesh. Gyan mean pure knowledge. So that you can discover the sense of relationship, sambandha tattva, avidya tattva, and prayojan tattva. See, in these three modes, if you can discover, then your diksha is perfect. I mean, sambandha tattva, first you know, then you, avidya, I mean, you practice, and prayojan, at least you can have the target. Avidya tattva mean, prayojan tattva mean, at least you should have some milestone, I mean target in front of you. Without target, nobody can come outside. Target should be there, one pure devotee. Eh? They are already reaching target, but still, they are gopikas. I can give example from Bhagavatam. Gopikas, they are always doing seva of Krishna. But still, they are speaking. We, tava katham ritam tapta jivanam kavi viritam kalmasapaham. Why Gopika speaking this way? Harikatha is one, is your bhajan mode. Those who are bonded soul, for them, Harikatha is the procedure of bhajan. But those who are established in bhajan, for them, it's a prayajan tattva. You cannot understand that. I have to explain this point. Don't get confused. For bonded soul, Harikatha is the mode of bhajan. But for those who are established in bhajan, Paramahansa, Nitya Siddha Parshad, for them, Harikatha, both. They can show that we are doing bhajan by Harinam and Hari, we are hearing Harikatha. But they are not actually, they are Harikatha itself, they are getting Krishna by Harikatha. They are meeting Krishna by Harikatha. So it is a very Prayajan Tattva. They are getting Prayajan Tattva. Understand? There is a secret point. This Gopika, they are speaking this, Tavakathamritam Sabanam. Tavakathamritam Sabanam. For Gopika, they are also speaking. They are Harikatha, we are hearing. Tavakathamritam, Tapta Jivanam, Kaviviritam, Kalamasapaham. Sabanamangalam, Simadatatam. Bhubiginantite Bhuridaje Jana. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after Rathayatras, he is taking rest in Jagannath Vallabh Udyan, in Puri, Grand Road. Now you can find. That time address was different. Now they change the address. But there, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu swaying. He is taking rest. That time Raja Pratap Rudra, those devotees, they say, you like to get the keep of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Now it is a chance. Prabhu is full ecstasy. He is lying in garden, enjoying the meeting of Krishna. Now he is excellent. Now you can go. This is a chance, but be careful. With very humble attitude. And base should not be very sambal dhoti and this sample. With cloth here, you can approach and you can sing from Gopi Gita. Tava kathamritam tapta jivanam. You can sing. Oh, really? You go. Now, Raja Pratap Rudra coming and touching the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and at the same time go singing Gopi Gita and messaging the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, without seeking this, who is coming to me? Vridajana, giving me so great treasure to me? Who is that? I have nothing to give, only I can give embrace. You see, there, if you can get the embrace of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what else you need to get? Mahaprabhu say, more kichu dita nahi dilu aningon. I have nothing to give, only I have, because I am penniless. I can give, I can embrace you. I can embrace you. Raja Pratap Rudra. Embracing. Giving everything. Full blessing of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Giving. But first of all, he took permission from Vaishnavas. Because Vaishnava is never regulated by anybody. But Vaishnava is regulated by pure devotee, I mean those who are their servant. Apparently, see, Maharaj, I am speaking contradictory, not that. Krishna is in Bhagavatam, first chapter, first sloka, Yanma adasya yato anmyadita rascharta savigya sarat. Sarat. Sarat means Krishna is never controlled by anybody. By the same thing, Krishna is speaking himself. Om Bhakta Pradhina. So, 2 points coming. Be careful. Very, very big Siddhanta here. Careful. Otherwise, if you can confuse, big problem. You can express doubt. So, first of all, he took permission from Shuddha Vaishnavas. And Sonatan and Rupa Goswami, when took the darshan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Ramkeli, there also you can find the same case. When at the night time, 12 o'clock night, Sanatana and Rupa came, very humbly. And first, Sanatana Rup, first they taking the kripa of Guru Varga, Haridas Thakur Maharaj, everybody, please permit us kripa, give kripa, so that I can approach Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They bless, go. Now they go and fall down. Oh, you fall down. Then get kripa. This is the procedure. You cannot jump. So you see, good association, pure association, one by one example I can cite from Bhagavatam, different shastra. One example, one by one I can speak. Today's time limited, I will have to go for other seva also. So now you see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking one, giving a nice teaching to Sanatan. In Sanatan Sikha you can find one hunter. He is in forest hunting different animals. By chance, Naradji coming that way. Then he become very angry, the hunter. Why you come this way? I missed my target to kill that. Huh? Deer, harin, hamara lakshabas bhrast hua. Why you come this way? Sorry, I don't know. What mistake I do? You come this way, I mistake my target? Excuse me. Oh, in the way I see some animal there, you kill them? Yes, I kill them. I kill them. I learned it from my father. Oh, really? You are killing this way? But yes. They are getting pain. They are expressing great pain. You don't kill them that way. I have some application to you. What application? Anything you want, I can give you. You need deer skin or tiger skin, I can give you. You can do bhajan. Oh no, I don't want anything. I have some other application to you. What application? Whenever you kill one animal, kill fully. Don't leave it half dead. Why? He is loving. Why? What benefit you can get out of that? Oh, no question of benefit. If you kill him half, if you make him half dead, then he feel pain. So what? We enjoy, you enjoy, but you don't know, life after life, they will kill you again. The way you are killing them, they will also, oh really, yes. Then by the mercy of Naradji, because Naradji has some influence, he gets some feeling, how to get rid of this maya. You go and take bath in river, then come to me, I can give Harinam. Like same example I told you, Valmiki Muni, Ratnakar Dashu, previously was, he could not utter. They give Harinam to Haridas Thakur. Then, Naradji is, he is complaining, Gurudev, how I can get prasadam? I may get it. I need to, because I am selling this to market. You need not kill any animal. You sit and do Harinam here and do the seva of Tulsi, automatically some prasad come to you. Oh, really? Yes. After some days, Naradji coming with his friend, Parvat Muni. Another Muni, Naradji Muni and Parvat Muni, his friend. Let us go to see one of my disciples. Where? Well, let us go, I can show you. Going. They are coming near Triveni, confluence of three rivers. Ganga Jamuna says, Naradji swing, see my disciple doing Harinam. He could see Gurudev coming. He fall down in field and paying dandavat. Before fall down, he clean the field with cloth. Because if any ant and small creatures there, if I pay dandavat to by my pressure, they can die.
No, Haridasa come near. Oh, Gurudev, you are coming to meet me. Okay. And prasadam you are giving? How you maintain your... Oh, Gurudev, by your blessing, we are getting so many prasadam. Don't sense a lot of prasadam. Lots of prasadam. We need this much prasadam. No, prasadam can come, you can distribute. This way. Now, Naraji explaining, see, Parvatmuni, Parvatmuni speaking, you are actually a touchstone. Parvatmuni is speaking to Naradji, you are actually a touchstone. If you touch anybody, can change. Haridas Thakur, touching the heart of Lakshahira. And Haridas Thakur touching Lakshahira. And Lakshahira became a touchstone. Not that Haridas Thakur touching the heart of Lakshahira and making her gold. Not that. Itself, Lakshahira become a touchstone. And in Chaitanya Bhagavad Gita, say, Lakshahira become great sand. And thousands of people now coming to take darshan of that cross. I mean now, great sun. In Chaitanya Bhagavad Gita. Bada bada mahanto, mahanti ta darshan ita yanti. In Bengal it is written. Bada bada mahanti ta darshan ita yanti. But even big acharya, they are going to take darshan of Lakshahira. So how is that possible, you see? Everything possible. What not possible by bhajan, but you will have to follow the exact procedure. And sadhu sangha, I can explain if I get time tomorrow. And when before starting your parikrama for one day or 2 days, I can explain about dhammatatta, how to do parikrama, and different deepa, their mahima. I can try to. Today I finish here. Please excuse me. I have some other seva. I have to go. I like to speak hours after hours, but if I go on, I cannot do that seva. So many. And also, I can discuss some point about Rasata. Any day, you can tell. Vāñca kalpa turvasya kipa sindhu bhavishva patitānaṁ pāpana bhavishna bhyo. What time now? Now 9 o'clock, huh?
Yeah.
9 o'clock. So you must maintain time, because if you can come on time, no, I know you are feeling trouble for that. You will have to take what is that. But anyway, you have to, that is called your testing. You have to go through some testing. I do mental worship, but after that I don't do worship. Because worship, I do archan at the time of 7 o'clock. But 7 o'clock I come here, I give a responsibility to somebody. You do, because this is my archan. I can explain this point.
Tomorrow
7
o'clock
here. Tomorrow, your parikrama when starting?
What?
Your parikrama. When starting? When?
Started already.
Oh. Your parikrama. You are not doing parikrama?
Yes, started 3 days ago.
3 days ago? Done? Parikrama done? Finished?
No.
Then what parikrama you do? Huh?
Now we came for
Harikatha. Nah, you parikrama?
Antarpip,
Godrumtip. Acha. No. Then within 2 hours we can finish Harikatha, then you can go.
Yes.
Huh? Yeah. If you feel thirsty, you can get green coconut also. I approve. Otherwise you can say, Maharaj, it's so low, heavy. I cannot go for parikrama. Then go. Gaurasunda. So long. Huh? I don't see you after Puri Purushottamda.
Yes.
You are missing. I don't find you. Now again I discuss. So I'm going, yeah?